All right, today I'm going to be diagnosing P0300, which is a random cylinder misfire on this Buick. Basically, the problem with a P0300 random cylinder misfire is it doesn't tell you, it doesn't identify which cylinders are actually misfiring. So I'm going to show you how to check these with, the misfires with a scan tool, and also how to manually test to find out which cylinder is actually misfiring, so you can repair it. I'm working on a 6-cylinder here, so basically out of the 6 cylinders, we need to figure out which one of them are misfiring, because the code we're getting isn't identifying the actual misfire, it's just a random misfire. So let's just double check the trouble codes here. And as you can see, we have the P0300 engine misfire detected. So that doesn't really give us a whole lot of information there. It just tells us that we have a misfire. So I'm going to go into the Tech 2 here. We're going to go into special functions and see if misfire graph. So we got a misfire graph here, and hopefully this is going to identify which cylinders are misfiring. We'll go ahead and open that up and I'll fire this thing up. And it is definitely misfiring, I can feel it. And as you can see, we got cylinder 6 and cylinder 3 are misfiring. So on this particular vehicle, it's got 3 ignition coils, 2 coils that run, or 3 ignition coils, each coil runs 2 cylinders. So it's a 6-cylinder, it's got 3 coils, each coil runs 2 cylinders. So first thing I'm going to check up, I'm going to go under the hood and see if cylinder 6 and 3 are running off the same ignition coil, which there's a good possibility of the IR coils are pretty common on these. But let's go ahead and go out underneath the hood here and dig into this thing a little deeper now that we've identified which cylinders are actually misfiring. On this one, it's going to be 6 and 3. Okay, and here we have cylinder 6 and cylinder 3, and as you can see, these cylinders are firing off the same ignition coil. So I'm just going to go ahead and start this thing up and see if we have spark coming out of the 6 and 3 ignition coil. And to do that, all I'm going to do is take a pair of pliers and pull the wires off. As you can see there, we got nice strong spark coming off the cylinder. In cylinder 3, we have nothing. In cylinder 2, we have nothing. So at this point, and you want nice strong spark, like you can see. Oh, yeah, coming off that one. That one actually almost stalled the motor. So we definitely have no spark coming off 6 and 3. So that's what's causing our misfire. So at this point, what we're going to have to do is we're actually going to swap these coils around, because at first thought you would think that it's a bad ignition coil, but on this motor underneath it is actually the ignition module. So each one of these coils has a driver that the ignition module powers. So to verify whether or not the ignition module is bad in this, or if the ignition coil is bad, we're going to have to, I'm going to go ahead and swap it with the cylinder 2.5 coil, which we know is working properly, just to make sure the driver in the ignition module hasn't failed. Also, another quick tip is when you're pulling these spark plug wires off, to check for spark. If you're using a pair of pliers and you don't want to shock yourself, a good way to avoid that is just take a little jumper and connect it from your pliers to a ground source. And if that ignition spark transfers to the pliers, it's just going to be redirected right to ground, so you won't get shocked. Also, if you're wearing rubber gloves, that will help. And before you start the motor, you just want to make sure the spark plug wires themselves, you've already loosened up a little, so you don't have to tug hard on them with the pliers, because you don't want to cause any damage to them. So now what I'm going to do, I got both these loosened up on this motor. It's just a 5.5mm socket. I'm going to swap the wires around, and I'm going to swap the coils. I'll also leave a link in the video description below to tune-up stuff you can buy on Amazon. I find they're the cheapest and the fastest for shipping. Yeah, and underneath these coils is actually two little prongs that stick in there from the ignition module that actually drives the coils. So basically, by switching these, like I said, we're going to be testing to make sure the ignition module is driving the coil properly. So, thus far, we know for sure we had no spark on cylinder 6 and 3, which is causing the P0300, the random cylinder misfire. So we've narrowed it down to what cylinders it is. We've identified that there was no spark coming out of that coil. And now we have swapped the coils to make sure that our ignition module is right. So I got these ignition coils swapped. I got the wires swapped around. We're going to go ahead and fire this back up. And we're going to use the same test to see if we have spark. Alright, so we got no spark now on the on this coil we just swapped. And the one that we did have spark, didn't have spark out of before, is now sparking. So in this case, the actual driver in this ignition module has failed. So our coil is good. Under the first assumption, you would have suspected that this coil was bad, but by swapping this, we have verified now that the ignition module in this is actually bad, and that's what's causing our P0300. Now, if you're getting a P0300, and you can't identify which cylinder is misfiring with a scan tool or other ways, usually the best way is just to come out and, you know, start pulling wires and see which cylinder is affected by you pulling those ignition wires off. In this case, it was pretty obvious to us that we had no spark out of 6 and 3, and, you know, we were able to narrow it down relatively quick. Now, in order to repair this vehicle, we're going to have to pull all three of these coils off and replace the module that sits down underneath it. Now, I'm probably also going to replace the ignition coil, only because typically, I mean, there's a reason why these parts fail. This ignition coil could be shorting. I mean, it could have some high resistance in the primary windings. And over time, it could have just stressed that ignition module. So I'm going to inspect the rest of the ignition components on this vehicle, spark plug wires, spark plugs themselves. And if those all look good, we're going to have to replace the ignition module. And we're probably going to be end up replacing at least that one ignition coil. But what's actually failed in our case here is the ignition module. Once again, thanks for watching. Hope this video was helpful on the P0300 random cylinder misfire. Be sure to hit the thumbs up button below and subscribe to my channel if this was helpful. Thanks. Flat Rate Mechanic.